Welcome to the Biscuit Boys Show with him, Mrs. Brown, and me, the Gabby Cabby, on SRB Radio in association with Northern Exposure and sponsored by the ELO Group. On tonight's show, we have music by Sheaf, The Tapestry and The Brazen, plus a whole lot more, and regular features, Today's TV, Rich or Huge, Agony Uncles, Twitter Time, The 400 Club, Yesterday's Papers, The Busy Fool and The Colin Ballin. But first, let's get kicked off with my record of the week, and this week it's In My Head by Vladimir. So fasten your seatbelts, Blind Dave, we're ready for takeoff. Vladimir In My Head, and a new record from Vladimir, I Try, coming out soon in April. We've also got a show, Faces at Northern Exposure on SRB Radio with Rachel Brown and Vladimir, up soon as you can cut it together.
Okay.
The new track is dropping in April, but they're going to send it to us, so we're going to have an exclusive first play and put it into our Faces show. Okay, anyhow, what a way to get Biscuit Boys airways above the clouds. Mrs. Brown, this week heading for?
Scarborough.
Yeah, you've been there, didn't you?
Yeah.
Did you like it?
It was okay.
Yeah.
It was okay. I liked...
Did you go to the fair?
No.
Scarborough Fair.
No, I didn't go there. No, forgot about that.
Did you go on the donkeys on the beach?
Too cold.
Did you go over those North Yorkshire moors?
Did
you shit yourself?
Not really, no.
They're high, aren't they?
They're pretty high.
They've got them blue things that you break your speed and you have to go over, and the shale on the floor, ain't they?
Where did you go? Flipping Iceland.
I went from Fersk in Leeds.
To second.
I went from Fersk to Leeds. Thirst by Leeds to Whitby Bay, Whitby.
Yeah, it's lovely.
So I've gone all over the North Yorkshire moors, and then to
be black in it.
Oh, so I was bricking it.
Yeah.
Oh, I hate Oyts. Yeah. I was bricking it, mate.
Some pretty steep hills there.
Tell me about it. But then over the North Yorkshire Moors, from Whitby to Scarborough, it's fine. Yeah. There's no sheer drops coastline.
No. Yeah.
But I walk very happy about it.
Yeah, it's nice, though. Very picturesque. Very destitute. What's the word?
It's very quiet and quintessential English, isn't it?
Yeah. What, Scarborough?
Yeah, it is, really. Yeah, and it's a northern lock. Yeah, it's a lovely northern town. We love
it
northerners.
Yeah, except for Bridlington.
Did you not like that?
You know, don't like it.
Okay.
You know, like the war. Yeah, Second World War.
What, one? We have loads. We've still got one now.
It looks like...
With ISIS.
It looks like, you know, after the war when they cleaned all the towns up and done them all up.
Okay,
looks like they forgot Bridlington.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a godforsaken hole.
Oh, you're sounding like me now, ain't you? You're not sitting on that fence like you used to, are you?
Oh, God, no.
So what was your best place that you went to up there?
I think Whitby's nice. Very nice.
Mm.
And I think my favourite place is Lincoln, the Old Quarter.
Okay, you was in the cathedral, weren't you?
Yeah, it's beautiful around there. Going to the Old Quarter. It's really nice.
Yeah.
Really nice.
And you've had your hair done as well?
Oh, yeah, I like it.
Well, it's like a different colour, isn't it? You put bleach.
It's the same colour.
It's not. You've dyed it.
Yeah, I've dyed it the same colour. I've gone for a more, yeah.
You are so vain, aren't you?
I wanted to go blonde. Ellen wouldn't let me.
Wow. Blondes have more fun, you know.
Apparently.
Yeah. Mind you, in your case, I'm guessing that they wouldn't. Anyhow, right, before we get our teeth into this show, let's invite the world into our monkey house.
Lights go down. We're gonna be rich tonight. We're gonna be huge. We're gonna be rich tonight. We're gonna be na 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 na. Lights go down. We're gonna be rich tonight. We're gonna be huge. We're gonna be rich tonight. We're gonna be na 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 na. Monkey gonna be huge. We're gonna be rich tonight. We're gonna be huge.
Whoa!
What? Hang on, I haven't done it all yet.
Hey? You were a bit slow there, weren't you? Is he still there?
He's been on all day, I don't know. He's still there.
Jack? The last one.
Oh, life's a bitch, Jenny. Don't worry, Jack. You'll be back next week. You'll do it all over again.
Yeah.
Anyhow, you ready for Rich or Huge?
Still just said something then,
did he? He's gone, isn't he?
Oh, he's gone now, yeah.
Yeah, of course. Well, you've got the buttons.
Rich or you.
You are like an echo, ain't you?
I am.
Yeah, Rich or Huge. You're going to talk about Jordan Dance.
Okay. Who's he play for now? Crystal Palace?
No. No, they're a group of dancers. On a Saturday, you know, with you, you'll get up, you do breakfast. What you've got to do, then you go to breakfast, then you do shopping, and trying to get a conversation out of you on a Saturday is like trying to get blood out of you. In fact, it's like trying to get one of our records played on national radio, isn't it? You know. I sit down there with my daughter in the cafe having a couple of cups of coffee while they do the ballet, while they do the tap, while they do all the modern, while they do all their dancing for the Jordan School of Dance. They're going over to Jersey in June.
New Jersey?
No, not New Jersey.
Old Jersey?
The Jersey, you know, that little island by France.
Yep.
You know. And they're competing in the World Cup for England. They are an unbelievably talented group. Possibly, out of all the stuff I've ever done, football, because I've been involved with football with my kids, you know, and from the age of about 7 or 8, they start playing football. But I'll tell you what, you watch kids of 7 or 8 playing football, and a lot of times they're all chasing the ball, ain't they? And it's all, it doesn't quite work until they, you know, start practicing a bit more and get a bit more, you know, about them. These girls, some of them, they've been dancing there from about the age of 4, and I tell you, and I do not jest, they are world class. They've got about 8 of these kids who are so brilliant. I watch them, and I tell you what, I've got a tear in my eye when I'm watching these kids. I was over at Castle Bromwich the other week. They had a competition. You can tell our girls from the others, and all the others are really good as well.
Yeah.
But they are just brilliant. There was one performance by a young girl, I don't give surnames out and I don't share things with the little girls, but one little girl named Lola, and I tell you what, her performance on this dance that she did, she would have beaten any kid anywhere on the planet. They still get little or no media coverage.
If I was professional, I'd have it lined up now with another Kinks.
Do you know something?
I'm not
there. Yeah, you would actually, but you're not.
Yeah.
If I'd got the money, I would heavily invest in them. I'd invest in the musicians that I absolutely love.
Yeah.
And I would do my utmost. I haven't and I can't, but I love them and I support them and I give them time. And there's one little girl in particular, Stella, she's been offered a 6-month extension to a contract as Veruca Salt in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory at the Theatre Royal in Drury Lane. She's doing phenomenal things.
Good stuff.
I think that kid's only about 8 or 9, possibly 10. Brilliant. You know, they have girls all the way up to, you know, 15, 16, 17 and possibly leaving school as well. But my focus is the girls, the little ones, and watching them perform.
Yeah.
They are fantastic. They're just unbelievable, mate.
Brilliant. I can dance, you know.
Can
you? I can do Irish dancing.
Well, you done it the other week,
didn't you?
Like
it, yeah.
We put it up on Facebook, didn't we? We posted it.
Yeah, it's my party
piece. You've got 2 left feet, haven't you?
Yeah, it's my party piece.
Do you often go to parties?
In the kitchen.
And they allow you to do it?
Yeah.
Okay.
They always find me in the kitchen at parties.
It's a bloke thing, isn't it? Mind you don't drink, do you?
No, not really, no. No, I think I had 2 pints or so over the week, in Lincoln and Scarborough. Yeah.
Is that the whole lot?
Yeah. Come on, interesting.
When's your next holiday? Because you do have a lot of holidays, don't you?
Well, I'm scared to tell you.
Come on, when's your next holiday?
It ain't long.
When is it?
It's in May, anyway.
May?
Yeah. It's got ages, yeah.
How come you have so many holidays? Because we can't cut you. How long are you going for? How long are you going for?
I'm only going for a week.
I need to get you divorced.
And then I got another one in June.
If I can get you divorced, we'll be all right. We can have a good run at it.
2 weeks.
We'll
talk about that when he comes.
Okay, come on, let's get the first track on, because we've got loads and loads of music today.
We've probably got the most we've ever, ever.
Yeah, well, let's crack on and let's play some then.
All right, I don't know what this is, what this track is. Oh, Major Matilda, Volcano.
Let's have it.
Here we go.
Bobbing on, isn't
he? He's bobbed off now.
Yeah. Bobbing on. What's he called? Bobbing on.
Major Matilda Volcano.
Is that the name of the band or the name of the... We don't know, don't we? We get things sent in to tracks@sports-radio.co.uk and we just play them.
We do?
Hmm?
Should we say something?
No, I just love sitting there and just saying nothing because it makes you panic.
Dead air.
No, I ain't got nowhere.
No.
I shave it all off every couple of days.
Because when I edit it, you won't hear that dead air.
Are you joking? I love the dead air.
No, I edit it. Don't want any dead air.
I like to get you sitting and poised like a coiled spring.
Mm. But it don't bother me.
What was that then?
That's the wind.
Flipping heck, it's loud, isn't it? Hey, today's TV, you been watching Line of Duty?
No.
With Vicky McClure?
No, should I?
Maybe not. Sorry?
Should I have?
Well, you know, it's a good series. It's a cop series, isn't it? It's really good.
No, is it?
That Will Mellor's in it as well.
Ah, who's that?
Well, he's been in a lot of it. You know me, I'm not very good with
the
TV actors.
He's not one of
the
2 points, is he? 2 points?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, right, okay,
yeah. And then there's that Danny Geezer. Do you know what I mean? I'm awful with me actors.
I know.
Because I don't watch much TV.
Not Danny Dyer?
No, not Danny. He's another one that's been in a lot of these British movies that you would instantly know his face.
He was Bigsy.
Was he? Okay. He played
Biggs, didn't he?
Played a brilliant part in Line of Duty. That's a really good, good production. Mm. Now, there's an interview with Vicky McClure on Northern Exposure. Mm. All the W's dot Northern Dash Exposure way, dot co.
I think he's a Northerner, isn't he?
Who? Him. Do you know? Miller. Again, probably.
I think he's from Sheffield, actually.
Is he really? You're probably more up with TV than me, because I don't, you're guessing now.
Sheffield or Manchester?
Yeah, well, there ain't a lot of differences. Nah. Just as more in the way. Yeah, I know it is, yeah. But as I say, there's an interview with Vicky on the website. Also, we're going to have as our guest next week, Johnny Owen.
Great.
On the show next week. Yeah. Who's in Svengali.
He's going there.
That's where. No, I don't think he's going to cut. I think he's going to be via Skype.
I like it.
Right, and if he brings Vicky in with it, if he come in and brought Vicky with him, that'd be amazing. I'm guessing this monkey house would be cleaned up. And
I've
be
cleaned
like,
up, have you not noticed?
Really?
Tiny, yeah. Look, I put them up there as well, eh?
Okay, And I've done an interview, I've done a review of I Believe in Miracles for the webzine.
Sixth thing, you. I believe in miracles.
Have you seen that film yet?
No.
Have you not?
No.
The greatest football story ever told. About Nottingham Forest when Brian Howard Clough got the keys to the football club in 1975. And took them out of the old second division into the first division, won it at the first attempt. You must have remembered them days, because them days that you were watching football.
Glory days,
weren't
they, so.
Yeah, the Halcyon days. Yeah. Them were the days when I was very much in love with the game. Mm. And I've watched the film probably 4 or 5 times now, and it is the best film that I've ever seen. I've done a review. It's on Northern Exposure. So click on to the webzine. And you can read that, and you can read all the other wonderful articles that Rachel Brown and her team put together, including a banging interview with Birmingham's own, well, Solihull's own, Steve Craddock. We've got an interview coming up with Bruce Foxton from The Jam as well.
Oh, that'd be good.
Lots in the pipeline.
Fantastic.
Northern Exposure, very much a part of this team with SRB Radio, and when we're not doing our shows like the Biscuit Boys or the Tilt and Talk, we have got 24-hour music on this channel.
Going 24 hours?
Yeah, well, I just said that. You are an echo, ain't you? You ain't with it today, are you? You know what I'm saying?
It's a joke.
And Exo Waves, No Fun, is going to be the Rachel Brown's record of the week that will be played a little bit later in our show, because all of Rachel's tracks of the week get played onto our shows. Mm-hmm. And also, her new show, Rachel's Top 10, drops on Friday, every other Friday at 9 p.m. Guys, get involved. Contact at northern-exposure.co. Come on, let's have another track. What have we got, mate?
We're going to play one new one from the Tapestry.
Love them.
It's called We Talk.
Let's have it.
We talk, we talk, you dance away. Although it's not yes, a lemon. Yeah, you're selling me a lemon. Yes, a lemon. Yeah, you're selling me a lemon. Yes, a lemon. Yeah, you're selling me a lemon.
As well as Ming City Rockers, Sell Me a Lemon. How much?
Yeah. Lemon pudding last night. Lemon pudding.
Really, a bit tangy, isn't it?
Oh, it was lovely.
Yeah.
That was a live version, by the way.
Yeah, I know, it was brilliant.
Very good.
You like the Dolly Trots
like
as well,
them,
don't you?
Yeah. I like them, yeah, different.
And first we talk from the tapestry.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Hey, we're getting through a few today. It's right round your garden, isn't that? Thought someone was being murdered.
kids playing football, isn't it?
Yeah, the dustbin men. That bloke's still knocking his...
He's still knocking his house out, ain't he? Yeah.
Why do people have a skip and then just overfill it?
They
all do, don't they?
Yeah, a lot of times it's the neighbours, isn't it? Come along and...
Do you think so?
Well, I'll put it...
When
it
goes, did you? Yeah, terrible you are, ain't you?
Yeah.
Are they going to bed yet? Mind you, you'd be asleep.
I'm in bed half 10, I'm asleep, mate.
And the Speedway show you're doing, let's have a quick chat about the Speedway show. You're going to be on TV, aren't you?
We're recording it this Thursday.
Okay. Is that why you've had your hair done and you shaved?
Probably had a shave too early. I've probably peaked too early.
How many shaves a week do you have?
Oh, well, how many shaves do I need?
No, how many shows do you have? I know how many you need.
One shave a week.
Really? Is that all?
Yeah.
You are a part of it,
I've got sensitive skin.
Have you?
Which is why I have the sensitive.
Well, you cream up a lot, don't you?
Yeah, I do cream up. I tend to cream up. Mm-hmm. So, so I only have the one.
Makeup, because cameras, they make you look fatter as well, you know.
Do they?
Yeah, put a few pounds on you. Right. Just wear stripy T-shirts.
Depends on how they film you.
No, don't. No, it makes you look a bit fatter.
Okay.
I look quite bulky on telly. Just wear stripy, you'll be all right. Or keep a top on, a black top.
Black top?
Yeah, black top.
Black top against green?
Yeah, they'll be all right. Hey, they met our corporate colours, really, ain't they? SRB Radio. Yeah, green, bit of green and black.
Yeah. I've got a banner coming.
How long's the show on for and where's it going to be? How can people look up and watch it?
It's only going to be a fortnightly show. And then every other fortnight, we're going to do the radio show.
What radio show?
Sleeve Heads Tavern, Pillock.
Right. Who are you doing the TV for? You've confused me now.
Oh, no, that's easily done. The TV is for... Big City Centre.
Big Centre TV.
TV Sport.
Then ones that don't get in contact with me and the music.
Big Centre TV Sport.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Different.
Oh, right, okay. Do they talk to you?
They talk to us. Mm.
Yeah, so. I think it's me, you know.
No.
I do.
I just think it's me. I've watched some of your rants this morning and I can understand why.
it just boils my piss.
Everything does. You were born to have piss boiled.
You know, my missy says that. Yeah, you are a moaner.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, she does.
You're a natural.
All you do is moan.
You're a natural Victor Meldrew.
I know.
You are.
We went to, it was my granddaughter's birthday party, went to Coastal Leisure Centre. We had a party on Sunday. And I said, all this bloody space they've got in Coastal. Coastal's massive, it's got loads of space. They put a leisure centre on, they've made 20, if you like, parking spaces. Is there any parking spaces? She can't park nowhere. Do you ever stop moaning? You haven't stopped moaning all the way from...
No, honestly, you do. You are a bit of a moaner.
Tell you what, I think she's about the only person on the planet that'd put up and marry me and live with me. Mind you, I'm not sure that's going to be for much longer.
Oh, no.
Well, you know, I just wind people up, don't I?
You do, yeah.
I just have this inability, don't I?
Yeah. You're good at it, though.
Oh, I tell you what. There ain't many people in this city I ain't pissed off, ain't there, really?
No.
Yeah.
No. Trying to think of one, no.
There's not, is there? There's no institution, really.
No.
But you see, the thing is with me, I say things that other people think.
No, you say things that you think people think.
Now, you look at the stuff that happened to me in football.
Yeah.
A lot of people would have thought exactly what I said, but I said it. They won't say it because it'd make them unpopular. You look at that, I had a managerial job at a non-league football club. I was commercial manager for 12 hours.
Yeah.
Six of them, I was asleep. And then they asked me to resign.
Yeah.
That was at the time when I was calling all the media panu's pets.
Please resign.
And I said,
please.
I'll walk away, right, quietly, but I am not going on social media and demoting myself. Now, it makes me look an idiot.
In fact, that was the best you job look, you never had.
I know. I could have done really good there as well, you know. Yeah. I was really looking forward to it and really getting my teeth into that. Because I like to do things that I think I can make a difference.
Yeah.
I like challenges. I would hate to be a plugger of somebody like really, really popular because I wouldn't see it as a challenge. I like challenges. I like the underdogs. You know, if I was born in any city, I'd support the worst football team there because,
you know,
that's just the way that they am.
Yeah.
And I just say things and annoy people. But, you know, when you have a gig in Birmingham and a band or tour and they'll travel hundreds of miles and then there's seven people watching them and one of them is a barmaid. And I go to so many gigs in Birmingham, my home city, that I love. And I see artists let down constantly. I listen to radio stations in Birmingham that are shite. Art FM, Capital and Free Radio are more controlled than both of them put together. It annoys me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll fight them. But, you know,
there you go.
So, sometimes what I have to do is resign from things.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Yeah. I've had to resign from most things I've ever done.
Resigning
him. Well, I do. Oh, but I'll jump on my sword and I'll say things for them because it annoys me. There's too many wankers in this world that just put up with it and just kiss their arses.
Where did you say wankers? 3903. Okay, just so nice.
Look, you can't take everything out.
I'm not. You just like giving me work.
I don't. You've just got to keep it in. It's raw, it's organic, it's me. Warts and all, that's what you get with me. Someone that'll run through a brick wall for you, but someone that won't take no shit. Now let's get some music on.
3927.
There's No Fun by XO Waves, that is Rachel Brown's track of the week on a Northern Exposure webzine. I mistakenly said No Fun earlier.
What is it?
It's called There's No Fun.
There's No Fun. No.
And you will be... Hey, they're coming in the studio.
Are they?
No. No, not now. Right. In a couple of weeks.
So I cleaned up.
Hopefully they'll either be in the studio or Skype. Just like Johnny's next week.
Okay, yeah.
And hopefully XO Waves, a phenomenal band from Stoke, hitting the right notes, making a lot of headlines, and also gigging at the RS Bar for our Tramlines Fringe gig on the 23rd of July. Hopefully you're going to be coming up with us.
Right.
The place to be, July 23. It's a Fringe gig, Tramlines 2016, 10 acts that are going to blow you away, the Incredible Magpie Band, the Velcro Teddy Bears, Pete Dixie Dreary, Purple Heart Parade, Exo Waves, Fire Garden, the Tangents, the Outfits, the Castellas and the Barretts, an acoustic slot by Nicola Jane. So guys, get on it, go onto the website, get your tickets. Well, it's a free gig to be fair, but just press the gig, we're going, let's all show up and we'll see each other at the RS Bar in Sheffield on the 23rd of July. We're going to have a love fest. Are you going to come?
Love fest. You're going to come? 23rd of July.
23rd of July. We're staying up there.
Oh, yeah.
Dennis
no,
is coming.
No, am I then?
Oh, again.
Yeah,
more. Oh, okay.
Right.
Okay.
Main holiday. 2 weeks,
isn't it? Is it really?
Yeah.
No, it's okay. Anyhow, come on, let's have back-to-back because right. We have got lots and lots and lots of tracks. So let's have back-to-back now, mate.
Okay, first track is Happy Dagger's Get Yourself Together.
Okay.
Followed by Dust and Somehow.
Let's have them.
Thank you. forgot to love one another. Is hot, but the people cold, and greed is rife when black is gold. And when I see them turn away, all hope is gone. It's not our day.
Different, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a lot. Very nice.
And yeah, we've got to go through Yesterday's Pipers. Hey, Sally Moore's done well again, didn't they?
I know, yeah. They're flying. Going places, aren't they? They're going places.
Conference?
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be great if a team brilliant. Like that got into the Football League as well? That would be a phenomenal achievement. Yeah, a lot of work to be done still, to be fair.
Oh, yeah. Sally should be able to support the Football League team.
Well, I mean, there was talk years ago. Do you remember when Birmingham were really bad? That, you know,
every couple of years, I think.
Well, like Solihull Borough, as it was in them days, Birmingham were going to play there, weren't they? And they were almost going to adopt Birmingham as their team.
Yeah.
You know, then there was plans that they were going to have a stadium on Bluebell Drive in Chelmsley Wood. Mm. You know, and have like Solihull Borough there, but then, you know, they merge between Moor Green and Solihull Borough.
That would be a cracking venue, I think. Good.
Well, the auto, I mean, it's like, it used to be the auto tech, but it's slightly changed now, isn't it? I can't remember the name of it. Yeah. But yeah, it's the same, but it's an extended version, isn't it? But a great little club. Fantastic little club, and it'd be wonderful. Because, I mean, they were the first Moor shows that I ever done, weren't they? Love me little bits and pieces there at Solihull Moors. The only thing is, I fell in love with music.
Exactly.
Really? And you can't do both.
No, that's your downfall.
It's one or t'other, isn't it? Football or the music. You can touch upon a little bit of both, but you can't give everything 100%. It's either one or the other. Someone has to go. And I just love the music too much. And the people that are meeting in music. Hey, did you read about Easter Watership Down?
That's right.
Did you hear about it?
Poor bunnies, yeah.
Hey, that 1978?
That was it?
Yeah, oh, I know. It's frightening,
isn't it? It was a mere slip of a man.
Almost 40 years ago. Mm. Did you hear what the parents were complaining about?
Were they were going about it being... Because you can't have this on an Easter because it's...
Well, Watership Down, like bunnies die, don't they? That's what happened with bright eyes. Yeah. I've never actually seen it. No. But I'm assuming that they died. I mean, a lot of them caught that myxomatosis or whatever, didn't they? And that killed a lot of them.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, a lot of people didn't eat rabbit for a long time.
No, still don't.
Well, no, a lot of people don't. No. But anyhow, Watership Down, it was on. Parents were complaining that there's too many bunny rabbits dying.
Yeah.
Do you know, I don't remember any of them watching Jesus of Nazareth and complaining about the same thing.
No, because he dies in the end.
Well,
he comes back.
It's what happened to Easter, didn't it?
It's a miracle.
Well, it did. Yeah. Who moved that stone?
Exactly. He was a big, strong lad.
But tell you what, wasn't it just?
Yeah. No, it wasn't Samson, was it? Because he was...
No, he had his hair cut off then. No, you weren't in them times, anyhow. You met Delilah. Did they ever have a baby?
What? My.
Hey?
My Delilah. That's his first name.
Was it really?
Yeah, my.
What was it, hey? Delilah was a bird. Unless he was gay. Samson was a bloke.
Don't knock it till you try.
No, I know, but Samson was a bloke, wasn't
he? Right, okay.
Do you know, you thought... No, I'm getting mixed up here, don't I? Yeah. Do you know, a lot of these stories in the Bible, very similar, aren't they?
They are, yeah.
Like David and Goliath, Samson. Yeah. It's all about, you know, strength and bits and pieces and what have you, any. Great floods, Babylonian stories. Yeah. Yeah. But no, I thought that they might complain about Jesus got crucified, but apparently that's fine. But they didn't like the fact that little bunny rabbits died. That's out of order.
Have you tasted rabbit? Have you tasted it, rabbit? Yep.
I must admit, I haven't. Not willingly and knowingly in the last 40-plus years. But I do remember going round all these restaurants on a Sunday with my ex-missus. And she just didn't like people. So we was trying to find a restaurant that was half empty.
Yeah, yeah. Look, there's no people in.
Exactly. So if you see one on the car park and there's no cars on there, let's go in there. I'm like, let's not. It's shit. That's why there's no cars on the car park. Or it's closed. Anyway, we found one eventually, having drove around for about 3 hours. So we gets in there. She got the menu. So I've got her in there. I'm absolutely starving. And she sat down, good menu, and she's gone, game pie. Oh, I think I'll try that. Right. And there's the waiter, standing there with his pen poised. She's going, is there any rabbit in this game? I'm going, no, just say no. Yeah. And he said, I'm sorry, is there any rabbit in this game pie? Yes. Right, come on, we're off. Oh, God's sake. I think we end up getting a McDonald's.
Yeah. And of course, it's all good stuff in McDonald's, isn't it?
Wow. You see, McDonald's isn't good for you, is it?
No.
No, it isn't, is it?
Well, no.
It appears to be not particularly good food.
No.
Well, it ain't good quality of food, is it?
No. Tasty, though, isn't it?
Well, but it ain't good for you, is it?
No.
Fast food, that ain't good for you.
The taste not is ain't good for you.
Yeah, but you look at McDonald's. They sponsor all these kids' sports events, don't they? They sponsor all these things on TV. Mm. So when these people are saying fast food and diabetes and, like, putting on weight and obesity in kids, and then they're letting McDonald's sponsor all the...
Yeah. Yeah. Can also say that McDonald's, they do actually get a lot of money in for charity.
No, again, for I'm not knocking...
Children's Hospital.
I'm not knocking McDonald's. But what I'm saying is, their food isn't supposed to be particularly very nutritious.
They would probably contest that.
Well, they may do, right? But, I mean, is it any coincidence that we've got a load of an obesity problem and we've got a load of fast food outlets, etc., etc.?
I think that's just because kids eat too much.
Well, I mean, there is a bit of that, isn't there? I mean, that hole's bigger than that hole down there, isn't it?
In your day, it was probably the same as my day.
We never had McDonald's.
No, but what I'm saying is, you had your breakfast.
Yeah.
You had nothing till lunch. And then from lunch, you had nothing till dinner. And if you didn't eat it, you got nothing, did you?
Well, I did, to be fair. I'd eat in between.
Would you?
Of course I would.
Why are you a strip of piss?
Well, this is what I'm saying. You know, we're all built differently, aren't we? Yeah. We have metabolism rates that are different, but there is over the... Oh, bugger off. Don't answer it. Yeah. Probably trying to sue me as well. I've, you know. But anyway, my take on it, these fast food outlets can't be good for healthy living. And they do seem to moan about them a lot on, you know, the media moan about them. There's lots of... in there. And then all you see is adverts of McDonald's and other fast food. Tell Ronald to binge jog on. Hey, clown. Come on.
Do a track.
Go on, let's play
this
track.
This is Chris and called This Ride.
Go on.
There you go. Like that.
You do, don't you?
I do like it.
I saw you do, yes, prick up. Yeah, and you go, well, I like things as different.
I like different, yeah. Good.
This was different. OAP swims to ship after it sails without her. Would you have done that?
Oh, I saw that, yeah.
How bloody ridiculous is that?
Yeah. But apparently she went pretty well, so.
Went pretty well? She needed to swim pretty fast. Oh, no,
right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, my kind of thoughts is like, how the bloody hell are you going to say you even catch up?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You catch up with that ship. How are you going to board it?
Exactly.
It'd kill you, wouldn't it?
Overboard! But actually, it's a woman. She's got her handbag.
I know, she was still clinging on to it,
well,
weren't she?
Well, that saved her life.
Did it? How?
Her handbag, because it was full of air, so...
So she used it
so
as a
float? I think you used my missus' handbag.
Or mine.
Or my daughter's.
Yeah.
It's a very satchel.
Oh, they put so much rubbish in handbags, don't they?
How is it called? Thanks.
God, yeah, it's his battered Katie, and it's flipping
me, I do.
Katie's fault. I'm new Alf Garnett, who? You know, there's only ever one, isn't there? Alf Garnett.
Yeah.
Oh, Phil, EastEnders. I'm sick of EastEnders. Do you watch EastEnders?
Watch EastEnders, yeah. Basically, because it's true.
Yeah, I know.
I don't watch the other one, though. I haven't watched Coronation Street for probably 20 years.
No, I don't watch anything, really. So I struggle with actors and actresses, if I'm honest.
You struggle with a lot of things, really.
Yeah, reading as well. I struggle with reading.
Reading?
I know. Star Keeley on her milestone birthday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she's 40. Still looking good, though, isn't she?
Who? Sorry?
That Keeley Bird.
Oh, Keeley Bird.
Yeah, you know the one that was in, Life on Mars, and that she was in Line of Duty as well.
Yeah, she reminds me of somebody.
Nice looking bird, that's who she reminds you of.
Yeah, she is.
Oasis was voted best band song. So I'm guessing it weren't like, you know, every song, but it's just bands there. So Wonderwall got number one, number two was Don't Look It Back in Anger, number three was Champagne Supernova, number four, Blimey Oasis won quite a bit. But that was by X Radio. They done a kind of poll. So, you know. What would your top British band song ever be?
Ever?
Oh, well, I'm guessing it was ever. You know.
Song ever?
I'll try and
read
this.
Are we talking
about
chart hits?
Now you're looking at anybody's hits, really.
Ever.
The past 50 years.
I'd have to think about it.
How long does that go back over 50 years?
Probably 50 years.
I know, but what? Well, I'm 50, and I.
Yeah.
So it goes back to the 60s. So the Beatles ain't in there.
Oh, come on.
I mean, do me a favour. Oh, the Beatles come in at number 13. What a load of bollocks.
And what are the
Beatles? To be fair, Oasis are like 1, 2, 3 and 4. Oasis are a great band. Stone Roses 5, Arctic Monkeys 6, David Bowie Heroes 7. Bowie was 8, Life on Mars with Keeley that was in there.
Arctic Monkeys?
Yeah. Number 9 was Verve, Bittersweet Symphony, another great. Rolling Stones, number 10, Gimme Shelter.
Oh, I do love that.
Okay. Albo, One Day in This Life. Number 11, do me a favour. Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody. Tell that bloke to jog on. You had no jobs Monday. You got no jobs today. And you ain't going to have no jobs tomorrow.
Go away.
And you ain't going to have no radio show if that keeps bleeding ringing, unless it's Ronald McDonald.
Facts, actually.
Facts, don't they?
No, I haven't got a fax machine.
But what's the point? It goes to a machine. Well, you ain't got a machine, so it can't. And then it types out things. Does, don't it? Yeah. Well, that's supposed to what it does. So, and then the Smiths got in. Pulp got in there with Common People.
Yeah.
But, and the Beatles come really down low. Oh, Joy Division, Love Will Tear Us Apart was number 20. Nothing from The Jam, nothing from Weller, nothing from the Style Council.
Well,
I can
understand that.
I can't take anything like that serious.
Are you upset now, ain't you?
No, I just think that, again, it depends what radio station.
Who's gonna ask?
Well, this is what I'm saying. So if there's like a radio station and it's like 90s radio play, it's all going to be Oasis and any of the Verve.
It's going to be Jam, Star Council, Led Zeppelin, Genesis. Yes.
Well, yeah, but again, well, as I say, it just depends. What Lonnie Donegan song did you like?
Is he that one?
I get mixed up.
I think
up.
He did, yeah.
Was he
did,
the bloke looking through the...
Skiffle band, didn't he?
Was he the one on the, what's it, I'm looking through the bedroom windows and the night? Is that
no, that's,
I
get, that's George Formby.
Ah, I get mixed up with him.
I think it's his brother.
Is it really? They sound similar, don't they? The old skiffles are getting everywhere, don't they?
Yeah.
Anyhow, come on, let's play another track.
Right then, okay. But, oh, we might have a triple on, I think, because...
No, let's have back-to-backs. We need a bit of talking. We've got to give a shout to Twitter time and stuff.
I'm going to do this in my best John
Peel.
My best John Peel voice. That's the first track. It's going... Hang the bastards.
Yeah.
like Biscuit Boys, Agony Uncles. She bought it our baby, but didn't tell me. I don't want to see my husband's love child. Well, she wouldn't, would she, really? Embarrassed by my granddad. Is that my grandkids? Right now? Or there's a shorter one.
Oh.
Yeah. It's like you say. Well, it's like advice that you know, we've already given. Should we do that? Because it's a bit short and sweet. And I struggle with reading. Terrible reading, I am. Mm. In answer to the 28-year-old man who is seeing a 17-year-old girl, I say go for it. What do you say?
17's okay, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is that legal? Yeah.
Yeah, of course it is. 16's legal.
Is it?
Well, 15 isn't, because Adam Johnson found that out. Mind you, that teacher, she was nobbing a kid, wasn't she, in the class?
Yeah.
You know, but she got away with it.
Why?
Well, she's a woman.
Ah, one more for one.
Well, it appears to be, don't there. I mean, there might be more to it than meets the eye, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but anyhow, I was 17 when I met my husband in 1967, and he was 30. We got married in 19... Yeah, that's getting a bit boring now. But the thing is, this is Margaret that said that.
Margaret!
It's about older relationships. You know, so I mean, that ain't, to be honest, that's not that, is it? 28 and 17, there's 11 years.
What about you and your missus?
11 years.
Is that?
Yeah.
Yeah, you like them younger, don't you?
I do, well, you know, I just like them.
Yeah.
You know. Well, I don't plan it that way. I've only ever been out with about four girls. You've been out with about 4,000, ain't ya?
Probably.
You have been with loads, ain't you?
Yeah.
You know, you've had more birds than I've had at dinners.
Well, you know, I'm fully grown.
No, I know you are.
Wasn't then.
No, I know. You told me about that with the what's it the other week, didn't you?
Know.
Yeah. The old willy warmer.
You said that was me.
No, you did. You were saying, I said, blimey, I'd need to wrap that round a few times.
Yeah, yeah. I'm only joking.
And you said I'd struggle for space.
I was only joking.
Yeah? Oh, well, there you go.
Have a sec.
Yeah. But no, you know, it doesn't matter how old a person is.
Mm.
You know, it's what you've got in common with that. Do you know, I could be married. Well, I couldn't because I'm already married.
Yeah.
But I could be married to a bird that's 50, same age as me, and have nothing in common with that.
Yeah, that's true.
Mind you, I'm married to someone 11. I've got nothing in common with her. But, you know, I would say that...
But they say opposites attract, don't they? So
I think it does, but I think that it's like anything. There's either chemistry or there's something there or there isn't. Mm. And I think in answer to that 11-year age gap, I've got an 11-year age gap.
Yeah.
And what's the lowest you go down to?
Legal.
would you go out, say like you're now, you're 50, whatever. Yeah. Say you were single, right? Say you're single.
Yeah.
We're married, so we can't. This is all hypothetical, right? So what's the youngest girl you'd go out with?
I don't think I'd even think about the age. I think if it was chemistry, I'd say...
All right, what's the youngest bird you'd give one to?
Probably about 17.
Really? Would you go that low?
Well, I don't know.
Mind you, you are a dirty bastard.
These days, I'd rather have a bacon sandwich, to be honest.
Would you? You're joking, would you?
Yeah.
Bacon sandwich?
Well, bacon egg.
So you had the chance of...
Yeah.
Out of, you know, a bit of...
Yeah. I'm not like you, you know?
I can't. When I was going to whistle, when I'm laughing, I can't whistle.
I know you can't.
I've never been able to do that.
You do it for one way round.
Yeah, well, you're clever, you know. But, see. but, so you would go down to about 17?
If
would you have love? You'd fall in love with a 17-year-old?
Oh, you don't know.
What would you have in common with someone 40 years your junior?
What would you have in common?
Well, I mean, it would obviously be sex, wouldn't it, I mean, it wouldn't, but what I'm saying, if you were shallow and it was like you were going down, it would just be a one-night stand. Oh, God. But no, if it was just for that person, but if you were going to have a relationship...
God, that'd be your missus, isn't it?
She don't listen to us. She don't like us. I get no support. It's only Tom.
You're actually can car up the wall when you're getting, I tell you.
There's only Tom that supports us out of all my kids. All my other kids just don't like it. I wonder whether they like me at times. So I think to have a relationship with someone, you've got to have something more than just a bit of knocky, ain't you?
Definitely.
And you've like, could
we're
you
digging ourselves out of it, aren't we?
No, of course we are. But if you had a relationship with a 17 or 18 year old girl, they'd just be too immature and too kind of, it'd never work, would it?
No.
Be all right for a bit, but it'd soon drive you up the wall. Take you to, like, Little Mix concerts and stuff. Oh, I couldn't do that.
I like the little chubby one.
You don't like Little Mix, do you? I've been in a...
Not music-wise, though.
No, I've been in another row and I've left me family and stuff.
Well,
I just said, you know, you don't have to dress like a slapper if you've got talent.
Yeah.
And you don't, do you? You don't. Why do you have to like take all your clothes off and hang your tits out just to sell a record? Or like with the blokes, you know, they've got the tops off and they're showing the six pack and all that. It's all bullshit and bollocks. If you've got natural talent, you don't need to do that. And what
it helps though.
Yeah, but it shouldn't, should it? And what happened? Do you remember the song Video Killed the Radio Star? When that came out, about 78, I didn't really know what that was all about. That was a very intelligent song, that was. And it was absolutely bang on. Because if you're listening to people on radio, you don't know what they look like, so you buy the records. As soon as you get all these videos, and most like music videos, or a lot of them these days, look like soft porn. You know, and that's what the kids look at. I think it's repulsive. I think it's disgusting. And I don't think it's right. And I think that if that's the only way that you can sell some records, then, like, the industry's fucked, ain't it? You know? And if it ain't, you know. Well, it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Really. So, no, I'd probably go down to about 30.
Yeah.
I would. Oh. I'd date a bird 20 years, 30 years me young, but not any... What's the matter with you?
I think you're good down on anything.
Metal, innit?
Just a little bit, yeah.
If you die, that would sound like someone dying. Does, don't it? And that's a compliment to people in the death metal fraternity.
Cabin boy jump ship.
I'll tell you what, I'd jump the fucking ship as well if that was playing on the jukebox. But again, it's not whether I like it. No. People know what my taste is. We play anything, it's immaterial. Whether I like something or not, send the tracks in to tracks at sports-radio.co.uk. We'll play you, we'll support you. I don't have to like it. I don't like metal. I don't like... There's a lot of things that I don't like, but we'll play it.
You know, and toffees with the nuts in
idea. Oh, I love them. I love Maltesers as well.
Thorntons.
Yeah.
Got to be the best toffee.
I know. The only thing is, though, you eat the toffees and they stick to your teeth.
I know.
And then, like, you get it off your teeth and all your filling's gone.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like a trip to the dentist, ain't it?
Yeah.
So that bag of rocks that's cost you about £1.50 ends up costing you about £200.
God, you're such a moaning old git.
I know, it's what my missus says about me. They all say that about me. I think it's my age, you know.
You slit me throat, so I'm in a bit. It's not worth it.
So, yeah. I think it's just getting old as well.
Yeah.
Does, innit? I mean, there's more miserable bastards old than young, innit? Mind you, some miserable younguns also.
But I think I reckon you were probably born miserable. You've got that. But you know, attitude, I think.
I'm actually not a miserable person. I'm a happy person.
I know, yeah. I am.
Yeah, but it's just things that just annoy me and piss me off, really.
Yeah. Yeah. And you have to comment on them?
I just struggle not to.
Exactly.
But, you know, it's an injustice thing that I don't like. Yeah. There you go, what can we do about it?
There's loads of injustices in this life.
That's a bleeding big rabbit, that is, isn't it?
It's not real.
Any?
Nah.
Ah, okay. Oh, we are there.
Trying to get them a pie.
Who are these there? Oh, Little Mix. Yeah.
See, one of them's got a nice dumpy one.
Now, do you know what? They look all right there.
Yeah, they've got clothes on.
They've got clothes on. Yeah. They look four good-looking girls.
Yeah.
And good luck to them. Uh-huh. Again, I don't like the music and I just don't like the industry. But if that girl was in a bar... I mean, going back to...
Oh, here we go.
I mean, if you were single...
I really do hope your missus is missing. Because you might be single after this.
No, what I'm saying is, they're good-looking kids, aren't they?
Yeah.
I would just prefer them to wear a little bit more if they were on stage. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
You know, we had any complaints this week?
Hang on. We're closing the door on that.
Yeah, do you have any complaints on this show?
Loads.
Yeah.
Surprisingly, most of them...
About me.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is, isn't it? Yeah. Surprised we haven't been closed down, to be fair, by standards, agents.
That's why we never give the email address out.
But we can't, can we? Yeah. Can we do a phone in? Well, we can, but we ain't got a phone.
Yeah.
You know, we struggle.
Yeah. Oh, dear, funny, isn't it?
Yeah, come on, let's play a track. Because we have got loads and loads of music to get through.
Talking of birds, these are magpies.
Brilliant. The incredible... Incredible magpie band, get it right.
Here we go.
Yeah.
the incredible Magpie Band, who will be at the Tramlines Fringe Festival gig on the 23rd of July. The place to be, July 23. And also on our live lounge, on the they'll be in Birmingham on the 30th of April for our live lounge at the so-called studios.
Fantastic.
Brilliant. Wonderful. Should we see what's trending?
Go on then.
Yeah, let's have a look. See what do you want, Facebook or Twitter?
I don't foresee. I'll leave entirely.
What do you prefer, Facebook or Twitter?
I think I prefer Facebook. It's just easier.
Okay. Chris Eubank.
Mm.
Do you see that?
Sure, yeah.
Good warning.
Watch the fight.
Now, is Chris Eubank his manager or anything, or did he just step in and just tell
his
son?
No, he is, yeah.
Oh, he's the manager?
Yeah, manager, yeah.
But what a responsible manager.
Yeah.
Steps in there and just said
he's
it, as he's seen it.
He's probably seen it all. He's seen it all.
Yeah, but again, you know, they don't have to, do they? But, you know, boxing people are, you know, it is a very, very, it's not a violent sport, is it? It's a gentleman's sport, isn't it? But a very dangerous sport. Yeah. And he saw what was happening. Why didn't the referee stop it? I didn't see
the
fight.
Know. Don't know, that's the...
Would you have stopped it?
Oh, yeah, I would have stopped it.
Really? Yeah, again, yeah. I didn't see it, so I can't really comment on
after
that.
After the, I think the third, I got to the third round, I did put on Facebook, said, this ain't going to go more rounds. That was the third round.
And what round did it go to?
10th, I think it was stopped.
Really?
Yeah.
And sadly, the boy's got a bleed on his brain now, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's in an induced coma at the moment.
Have we heard anything more about him?
I think they're going to try and bring him out today.
So. Okay, well, all the very best to him. What's his name? Okay, as I say, I'm not into my boxing, so I don't know.
I can't think of his name. I'll tell you in a bit.
Yeah, but all the very best. And well done to Chris Eubank. You know, hit him round the body. I heard that, but hit him in the body. Don't hit him round the head, you'll hurt the boy.
Yeah, and even he was saying, you can't understand why he's...
Yeah, I know. Rhiannne Sugden is number, model is again receiving text messages from... Oh, blimey, let's have a look at that. Vernon Kay's at it again then.
Oh no, didn't he get in trouble, didn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, Blackwell, his name was the boxer.
Oh, okay. Kay, who apologised publicly to his wife Tess Daly in 2010 for sending Sugden and others sexually explicit texts. It's a mouthful. Don't comment. Yes, over the past 3 months, sent Sugden hundreds of new texts. The Sun reports. Well, if it's in... Do you know what I mean? If it's in the Sun, who knows? But anyhow, it's trending. The White House, it's in lockdown. Bloody Egypt flight. Hostage release. Oh, God, hijacked.
Yeah, that's right.
It's apparently getting stupid, all this is now, isn't it?
A domestic issue, apparently, that is. I've just heard.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah, on the White House. It's going through now on the White House.
Glastonbury Festival, they've announced the full lineup, haven't they, for Glastonbury?
Yeah, who's on it? I know Hilo are on it. Where else are
you? Yeah, you might be going, might you?
I might be going.
Yeah, you're excited.
I would be, yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Who'd you like to see at Glastonbury?
Oh, now?
Yeah. Oh. Say if I said to you, right, you can go to Glastonbury. I've got you the ticket.
Yeah.
Where would you head for? What would you... Because there's about 100 stages, isn't there?
Oh, right, yeah. No, I'd probably head for the Legends.
Would you really?
Yeah.
See, I'd go for the little stage.
I'd probably go and see all of them, but, yeah.
I'd want to see the bands that I'm linking up with.
But there again...
Unless Weller was on the Legends, then I'd want to see Paul.
Some of these artists you ain't never going to see again.
Like who?
Realistically.
Yeah, my belly.
Yeah.
Yeah. who then, like, you know, Jeff will play again, won't he?
I know, but you're trying to get a ticket for see Jeff. Probably difficult.
Is it really that difficult?
Really difficult, yeah.
Well, he wants to come and play the Sunflower Lounge on a Monday night or the Victoria on a Friday, Saturday, you know. We'll all turn up then.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? So anyhow, that's I think that's is that Jim or when he's... Hold on, let's just get it. Oh, Batman as well. Batman versus Superman.
I want to see that. It's
supposed to be shite.
Oh, is it?
It is, yeah. It's, oh, it thanks. Ain't been well, you know,
who
I don't
shite? People who don't like it.
Well, people that like it ain't gonna say it's shite, are they? No. Really, for truth.
So what don't they like about it?
I mean, it's been a massive box office smash. I think it's earned more money than any other film in the history of films.
Yeah. It's only been out since Friday.
Yeah, I know, that's what I'm saying. It really has smashed it. But There's been a lot of negative reviews, so I believe. Again, I haven't read it because I'm not really that interested in Batman or Spider-Man. But if you had to take your pick, if you was fighting against the Joker or some of these knobheads that fight, you know, who would you have on your side, Superman or Spider-Man, and why?
Well, I'd have to have Superman because he's...
Why?
Well, he's multi-talented, isn't he? He's got more powers than anybody else.
How?
Batman hasn't.
Well, Batman's just a bat, isn't he? Dressed up as
a man. He's got utility belts. And Robin.
Yeah, I mean that. Yeah. But I mean, Batman, to be fair, wouldn't be much use, would he, in a scrap?
Not really, no.
Yeah. No. But Superman...
Yeah, he's got them eyes that zoom lasers and stuff.
Does he really?
Yeah,
but is he not controlled by kryptonite or something like that?
I don't know what his name is. I don't know what a name is.
But you see, say you're Batman...
Yeah, okay.
Right. And you're fighting Spider-Man or Superman, yeah. You ain't going to have much chance because you got Robin. They'll go pow, bat, zap, and whatever, and you just go,
pshung,
and like, you're gone. You know what I mean? You're toast.
It's not true to life.
You're toast, ain't you, Batman? But like with Superman, right, Superman's got these powers. Has he got like fire as well in him?
No, I think that's somebody else.
So they've all got one that's of two bits. Is it really? So the beauty of Spider-Man... He can spin a web at any time. Spider-Man.
Does whatever a spider can. Does.
Spins a web. Well, I don't know the rest of the words. But say Spider-Man. Say Superman was coming at you.
Yeah.
Right.
Ooh.
Yeah, I know. All you'd need to do is just get your what's it. Spin the web and you've got him, ain't you? So that ain't no good. Unless you can cut yourself out of it. So like Spider-Man would win there. Hey, did you see Rock Scissors? What's that game that they play?
Rock, scissors, paper and...
That thing
sausage.
There. Did you see the England players playing that at half-time? Did you know? Did you watch the game?
Didn't watch the game.
No, I didn't. But they played very well and they beat Germany in Berlin. So that was superb. But no, they were playing rock, scissors and thingy, whatever they do. Yeah. Glastonbury, anyhow, it's the 22nd to the 26th of June. Now, I'll be at the Apollo Festival in York. On the 25th. Cutting a show, Faces at Northern Exposure on SRB Radio with my mate Rachel Brown.
Brilliant.
Okay. More about that festival next week, because we're going to be talking towards the end of the show about another festival, and we don't want to confuse people, because I'm confused already.
Confused.
I need to lie down in a darkened room. Come on, let's have a song.
Right, okay. We're going to play... Ooh, this is appropriate for you.
What is it?
The Comedian.
Dangerous, dangerous on the inside. I need you to keep the hurt inside. I need you to keep the pain alive. Who am I hurting, who am I hurting, who am I hurting, who am I hurting? Who am I hurting, who am I hurting, who am I hurting, who am I hurting? Smiling, smiling on the outside. I need you to laugh out loud. I feed on you, I feed on your. Who am I hurting? Who am I hurting? Who am I hurting?
and Gabby's not here, so I think I'll just bung on another track before he comes back. He's Chasing Dragons and Devil in Her Hoist.
Rocky, in it,
very rocky.
There's a load of rocky stuff.
It's a rocky day today.
Oh, it is. Yeah. So, if any of my mates that are like in mod bands and indie bands, please, send us tracks to tracks@sports-radio.co.uk. Talking of mod and indie, come celebrate the release of Well Suspect Records compilation Generation Mod. That picks my ears up straight away at the Barracuda store. 14A Newborough Street, London, W1F.
Pricks?
Hey?
You said that picks my ears up. It should be that pricks my ears up.
I don't know what you're going on about there. W1F, 7RU, 6 till 9, best dressed in Barracuda clothes competition, DJ... Well, you ain't going to win the best dressed, are
See,
you? Let's be truthful.
You're contradicting yourself now. You're talking about Little Mix. And then we're going on to clothes.
I'm not got a problem with clothes. Just wear the bloody clothes is what I'm saying.
Oh, I think you're contradicting yourself.
Oh! Look, if I went there with me bollocks hanging out, do you think I'd get best dressed?
Yeah, but you might have good music.
You might get a contract.
Yeah.
Yeah, might get fucking exactly. Locked up. Right. Anyhow, this will pick your ears up or prick your ears
yeah.
up. Okay.
Let's have a prick instead.
Free booze.
I'm there.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying. And that's on the 29th of April. So if we could get the day off, what day is that? It's Friday. It's a Friday.
Something's happening on Friday, isn't it? No?
Well, this is happening clearly on Friday, isn't it?
Okay.
On the Saturday, we've got the Incredible Magpie Band at So-Called Studios.
Yeah.
And on the 28th of April, Rachel is being a judge
in the
All About the Music competition, which we're going to talk about that later, because I met up with Dermot O'Flynn, who's the organiser of the the All About the Music, which is connected with the In Music Festival in Croatia.
Oh, yes.
Okay. I met up with Dermot, and the interview follows the Biscuit Boys show. So anything that you want... What do you want to know?
If I get it together.
No, you better get together, okay. Is what I'm saying. What do you want to know about the In Music Festival?
What do I want to know?
Yeah, what do you want to know?
Is it going to be warm?
It's in Croatia.
Ah.
Yeah.
It's not all warm in Croatia.
Hey?
No. If you go up high...
Yeah, well, like...
Colder?
Well, I suppose if you go up
I've been to Croatia. Twice.
Have you really? Whereabouts?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's probably the Croatian tourist board now. But Croatia is a warm country.
Not all of it. It's a beautiful country.
I mean, it ain't warm in the winter, but in the summer it's warm, ain't it?
Yeah.
Hey?
Yeah.
Okay. So anything you want to know, it looks lovely.
It does. Oh, it's a beautiful country.
And it's on an island.
Is it Hvar Island?
Is it what island?
Hvar.
I'll find out exactly. In fact, instead of going to Scarborough, right, that we did, let's literally drop into Croatia, play a record, and let's get it up, and then we've got the show that follows it as well.
All right.
Okay, come on, what we got now?
This is Don't Chase Me.
I'll never will.
Day old age.
It doesn't matter what you look like, everything is alright, you're still an open book. What makes you think he doesn't want you, don't you want to have another look? The minute he sees you come walking out of the room, you hope that he'll notice you glowing just like the moon. It doesn't matter what you look like, everything is alright, everything is alright. What makes you think he doesn't want you, don't you want to? Let's give up tonight. If he would only say how beautiful you are. What's it gonna take to get into your heart? When did you get so romantic? Is it automatic for you to wear your heart up on your sleeve? Now you're breaking through the static. How it would be tragic if you didn't tell him before you leave.
Always
that was Neil and Adam and Everything Is All Right, not the track that I said it was going to play.
No, because it didn't play, did it? I know, sometimes it just drops off.
It might be because it's been sent in format we don't want.
Well, MP3 all the time, isn't it?
MP3, please.
I do forget to say that track's at sports-radio.co.uk in MP3. Not
can WAV. Play WAV, but it means
yeah, but you time. Prefer, you've got to convert it and stuff. And you've got too much to do already, haven't you?
How much time do you
I know,
got?
That's what I heard every day off you. And you say I'm the moaner.
Yeah.
And also send tracks to contact at northern-exposure.co. No, .uk. Mm. No, com. Mm. Just .co. Go on then, have you got the festival up?
So it's in Zagreb, isn't it? Zagreb.
Yeah. Zagreb ain't on the coast.
No,
it's not. So it ain't going to be by the sea.
No.
But it's on a little lake, because they must have little lakes in Zagreb. And it's got a lovely little, like, bridge that you walk across.
Oh, right.
Dermot talks to me about that bridge.
Yeah.
You know, they've got little boats and stuff, because if you fall in, if you've had a few, I'd bounce, wouldn't I? I'd never get over that bridge.
Nah.
It's one of them swingy bridges as well.
Oh, right.
Yeah. It's not oil.
Well, even got the hand actions in.
Yeah, no. So do you remember Wemba Beto, when he used to score the goal and he done that with the baby?
Yeah.
It's like a swingy bridge like that.
Yeah.
And so you were saying that you've been
all around
there, right?
Yeah, I've been all around there in Kosovo and Montenegro before the war. Well, a few
months
before the war.
There's always been bloody wars, isn't there? It's ridiculous, isn't it?
Beautiful country, though. Yeah. Beautiful. Croatia is absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah. And it's in Zagreb, which is the capital of Croatia.
Yeah.
Come on then, let's get it, let's get anything else up there. Where are we now?
Hang on.
Is that the lake?
That's the lake.
Yeah, there's the what's it. So you've got the camp there, then another camp. So you've got an awful lot of water.
And
there's the festival site there on that big island.
For our listeners, what's happening is there's a road that basically runs through Camp 1.
Yeah.
We'll call it Camp 1.
Camp 1, what it is.
Camp 2, yeah.
Yeah.
And then another bridge leads on to the actual festival, which is in the middle of a lake.
Big lake, yeah. Looks I tell you what, I don't know how big it is, because I've not been, it's been going 10 years now.
Yeah.
And I've seen the video, Franz Ferdinand are talking on there, loads of people have played it, it's a biggie. Mm. Florence and the Machine are headlining it this year, but I bet you there is no more beautiful, in terms of surroundings, etc., than this festival at In Music Festival in Croatia. And there is a competition to enter. Because what, all about music, what Dermot, one is going to tell us later on, is that there is a spot for an unsigned artist to open up the show.
Brilliant.
That is a... I mean, I wouldn't say it's a once-in-a-lifetime, because if you don't win it this year, you can try it again next year. You know, it's running concurrently, and we're going to be following it.
So it's a once-in-a-lifetime every year?
Well, I suppose it is, yeah, really. And Rachel is going to be judging in the final. She will also be following the band, whoever wins, all the way to Croatia.
Right.
With one of our recorders to record a special programme. So we're getting everything about the band turning up for the final,
brilliant,
to the band winning the final, to the band going and gigging and opening this wonderful festival.
Fantastic.
In Croatia. So as I say, keep listening, guys, all about how much the tickets are, how you can obtain the tickets, how you can get involved in this wonderful competition. It's all on there, and I can tell you, but the best person to talk you through it is Dermot. In his words, he's the organiser. Okay, come on, let's have another track.
Right then, okay, is I Love Ya.
Do ya?
Girl, I wanna let you know I love ya. Girl, I wanna let you know I love ya.
I've been hiding my feelings way too long, and my feelings for you are getting so strong. Next time I see you, gonna tell you how I feel. And I'm gonna tell you how my feelings are real. Yeah. And I just wanna let you know that I love you, baby. Yeah. will you do? I just wanna let you know I love you. I love you. Girl, you know that I do. Every time when I have a chance to tell you, I start to choke up inside and I just don't know why. But I gotta tell you how I feel before it's too late, because losing you will be something I will hate. To tell you how I feel is so hard, I just wanna let you know that I love you. I love you, girl, I truly do. I just wanna let you know I love you. I love you. Girl, you know that I do. Girl, I got deep feelings for you, but I don't know how to tell you. My love for you is deeper than an ocean, and it's wider than the widest sea. Every time I see you, my heart starts racing, and I just wanna let you know right then and there. I love you, girl, I truly do. I just wanna let you know I love you.
Bit dreamy, innit? Cool. You could drop off listening to that,
yeah,
couldn't you?
Yeah, I love that, innit?
That's your kind of style, innit? You know, different.
Nah, it ain't. I like anything.
You like things.
I like things
that are different, don't you?
Yes, I do.
You don't like my music, do you?
I like some of it.
Yeah, I know, but generally speaking, you like your music more weird. You do though, don't you? I bet you like Yes.
Of course I do, yeah.
That's what I'm saying. They were weird, weren't they? I got a cousin.
Why were they weird?
They're weird. My cousin, Robert, he was perfect
cousin. Yeah,
and he was proper into like Genesis, early Genesis, and Yes and all that. You know, and I used to listen to him and think like, God, this is weird. It's weird music. So, you know, I mean, good luck to them and crack on with it. But it just didn't, between my ears, it just didn't hit that one cell. You know.
Mm.
But again, it does with you. You know, I like more kind of up-avit guitars, mod, indie, bands like that. By the way, have you got anything like that on the show? What are you doing anyhow?
I'm just...
You're typing away like a little typer.
I tell you, I'm replying to fans, you know what I mean? They keep...
What?
Well...
Was that plural or just fan?
Okay, our fan.
What did they say?
Will you play this?
Yeah, of course we will.
Of course we will.
We play anything.
Yeah.
Did they say they like the show?
Yeah, of course, yeah. They love the show.
I bet they never
listen to it every week.
I bet they don't.
They like the one that's not bald, apparently.
Yeah, the one that dyes his hair.
Yeah.
You do look like him, though, don't you? I mean, if he ever gets bumped off, that Korean leader, that could send you in there as his double.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm. And I'll tell you what, if you wore the uniform, you certainly would get away with it. Hey, have a guess who I'm going to watch on the 15th of April.
Who?
Lazy Eye.
Oh, right.
Yeah, they're playing the Actress and Bishop.
Great band.
And, so I'm going to meet up with Scott and do a little Faces at.
Fantastic.
Northern Exposure. Show with him.
Great stuff.
We're
great
loving stuff. Lazy, aren't we?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, how hard again how hard he's always at it, ain't he? And he still ain't found that bird, has he?
Apparently he's always at it.
Yeah, not with her though, that Katie Jones.
No.
She ended up everywhere, didn't she? Liverpool, Manchester. I bet she's even at the Well Suspect record launch and all, with the Mod Generation. If I was you, Scott, I'd look down there, I would, on the 29th of April for Katie Jones, because I'm guessing that's where she'll be.
Katie Jones.
That's another one, then, isn't it? That's Steve, that's Katie Jones, isn't it?
Yeah.
Remember that in the school holidays?
Yeah.
There was that champion, the Wonder Horse. Who was them Banana Splits?
Yeah.
You know, we had all those shows, didn't
Black
we?
Beauty.
That was another one, wasn't
it? I can't
it?
Remember the theme tune now.
No, I can't. No. But there was, did we say Champion the Wonder Horse?
Champion Wonder Horse.
You sound a bit like him. That's him, old Whip Crack Away bloke, innit?
Is he?
Yeah.
Whip Crack Away, Whip Crack Away, Whip Crack Away.
No, not him. The other one.
No, it's any
of his. Who was the cowboy? The cowboy bloke that used to sell shed loads.
Hey,
it was him. No, he didn't sell shit.
I sell loads of sheds. I'm a cowboy.
I couldn't sell a record, but I sell loads of fucking sheds. No, it's him, Frankie Lane. Frankie Lane sung that, didn't he? Champion of the Wonder Horse.
Did he?
I think so. Sure? Let's have a look at that play record. No, let's get it up.
Okay.
Who we got on now?
This is hot in. So hot.
Ah, Jesus, ooh, man.
Wow, that's hot.
Who is it?
This is our trick station. Or even, transfiction?
You trying to wind me up?
Are
ya?
I can't help it. It's just the way it's just the music that's sent in. You know what I mean? People do like music that you don't like.
I know.
I'm afraid.
Again, that sounds as though that bloke was dying, wasn't it?
People like different things.
Yeah, I know. Genres. So we're playing.
Yeah, we're playing.
So Rachel shows up on Friday, okay, 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
Rachel's top 10.
Yeah.
I should be listening to that with intent.
She can get it into me on Thursday.
Yeah,
help.
Yeah, I'll have a word. I'll phone her up later.
Yeah, I'm busy on Friday.
No, I know. I'm busy. I'm busy. I've got things to do. How much time do you think
I've
got?
I'm running a
multi-million. I'll write down exactly what's coming next when I ask you a question.
I'm running a multi-million pound conglomerate as well.
Yeah.
As well as
I know what you're doing.
A radio station.
Yeah. And it's like trying to send stuff into you.
You know what
it's
mean?
Like
TV star.
I mean, I know you are.
I've got so much going on.
I know. But you never answer your messages, do you? You don't?
Well, I thought about it.
When did you send that, Gab? Like yesterday, the day before, the day before. Well, I ain't seen it.
I can't help it. You know,
when's the show going to be up? 12th and ever?
By the way, there's a show up tonight.
What
last
one?
Night.
What
was it good?
What show?
Electric Legoland. It was on last night.
Oh, you got Adam's show on?
Yeah. It was great. That was
quality.
There's some crackers in there.
Every other Monday at 9 o'clock following the Tilt and Talk show.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Rachel's top 10 every other Friday at 9 o'clock. And the other Friday on 9 o'clock is filled with Gabby's biscuit tin. And my next biscuit tin will be all of the indie bands that are playing at the Tramlines Festival and our Bank Holiday Festival up there at the RS Bar. With
can I do my show?
I want you to do it.
I never have time because I'm doing everybody else's show.
Adam does his show every other Monday.
Yeah.
Right, Adam J's show, Electric Legoland, every other Monday, 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
I've been telling you now for 4 weeks, I want Chris's rock show. Or Chris's whatever. Chris's weird show. Mm-hmm. Chris's all the songs Gabby doesn't like show. Chris will put them on. And then Rachel... You share Mondays with Adam.
Pardon?
You share
Mondays
with Adam. Now, if you're not going to do your own show, give Adam an extra show. So we've got a show.
How much bloody time do you think I have?
How much time does it take to get one of them shows together? Your Chris's...
Ages?
Your Chris's show.
Last night?
You don't have to do anything to that. All you need to do is put 10 songs that we have here at the biscuit tin, right? So you put them together, say, hello, welcome, thank you, good night, ta-ra.
You think it's that simple, don't you?
All right, how long does it take you to do?
Well, just last night, just downloading the tracks and ripping them.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Converting.
Yeah.
Then compile them in the right order.
Oh, my God, you're going to go through the whole lot, aren't you? You're going to tell me what you had for tea as well.
That's before... They have to go through
making a cup of coffee for the missus,
right? Through some broadcaster for how long the show's gone, record it, then has to go back into Audacity, right? How long do you? It don't take 2 minutes. These shows, I'll tell you.
Right now, it's like my biscuit tin is all the stuff that we've really got in our app. On the next one,
they don't take so long because they're done.
Thank you.
Most of the music, there's always one.
Thank you.
Can you get this for me?
Okay.
Where?
Thank
is
you.
It?
Right. Okay. Right. So your show is all the stuff that we have on the Biscuit Boys, which is already in.
Yeah.
That won't take you long.
No, thanks.
Exactly. So 9 o'clock, Chris's show, Adam's show the following Monday, then it's yours again. Right. Then on the Fridays, I share Friday with Rachel.
Yeah.
Okay? Gabby and Rachel's biscuit tin and
biscuit.
Top 10.
Yeah.
Okay? Are you straight with that?
I'm straight.
Okay, let's play another song. Yeah, I'm loving it. You're going to put all these into my...
Yeah.
To my music folder.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
Anyway. And then I'll just delete a few.
You can't say that.
I can, I just did.
This is our audience.
It doesn't matter. I still love them.
Yeah.
I still play them. I don't have to like the music. You know, anybody that knows Gabby knows he's a miserable bastard that doesn't like rock, doesn't pretty much like rap and stuff like
prog,
that.
You don't like that.
Grime and... But we play them.
Yeah.
And we link
up.
We
like jingly jangly things. Jingly jangly songs.
I just like my music.
Yeah.
You know. If you think of Weller...
Yeah.
Anything that sprouts off and branches
the
off.
The Weller Tree.
Sounds like the Weller Tree.
Go through the Weller Tree again.
Don't have to. Do you remember when the old good old... Ah, bloody hell that hurts. The good old days. Yeah. Good old days, and like every other song was one of my songs that I bought.
That's right, I know, yeah.
And it was like my show. It's like been taken away from Gabby. But now I've got my biscuit tin.
Pretty boring, though,
15 tracks, old and new, picked by me just for you. And it'll be indie modern soul. Mm-hmm. Come on then, let's crack on, because time is pressing. Hey, did you put the clocks forward? Did you remember?
Of course I did. How would we be here doing
no,
this?
No, I know you have now. I mean, it's Wednesday night now. Yeah, but I mean, like, on Sunday.
Mm.
You remember?
Yeah. Of course I did, yeah. Well, you didn't.
No, I remember. See, I live most of my life on my phone.
Yeah, that's true.
She tells me off about that as well.
Has she?
Yeah, she always does.
Yeah.
Does
she know who you're talking to as well? Yeah. Has she seen a picture of the person you're talking to? Yet. Up until today.
You mean you?
I'm guessing she hasn't.
You mean you?
No, you know, Rach. Does she know about Rachel?
My wife knows all about Rachel.
Good.
Because I was telling her,
we're
friends, we're good mates.
Right, okay.
We love the same kind of music.
Good.
And I found, as I said, you was the hardest working person that I'd ever met before I met her. You're number two now. Yeah. I can't talk to you on a Saturday or a Sunday, but I can talk to Rachel at any time.
Yeah.
And she phoned me up the other morning at 8 o'clock.
Oh, right.
Saturday
okay.
morning. Because she phones me up at any time.
Yeah.
Gabby. Love the accent.
Gabby.
You know, and
Welsh.
Like, sorry?
She's Welsh.
Rather than Welsh. Yeah. But you see, this is it, and that's what I like. I like people that I can work with, that we can talk to. I've got an idea, or they've got an idea. They'll phone me up. Mm. It could be any time in the morning.
Mm.
And like, if my phone's going, and like Sam and I, phone him, like wake him up. Mm. I want him. You know.
Oh dear.
Talk to. I tell you what, you've got a filthy mind, you have to remember that I'm not like you. You shouldn't judge me by you.
Judge you by me at all?
Yeah. Come on, let's have a track. What we got? Hope something decent.
Every time I get a knife and I fall back and forth.
That was Punchline from Chiefs.
Yeah, a bit of Arctic Monkeys.
Lovely. That's more to my kind of taste.
Yeah.
And the XO Waves will be joining us on the 13th, Wednesday the 13th, but we will be recording it on Tuesday the 12th. So don't get confused. It's very confusing, I know.
I'm confused.
But, you know, they will be on the show in 2 weeks' time, I guess is what I'm trying to say in a roundabout fashion. Right, come on, mate. We better have another song, hadn't we? Right. Because we are pressed for time. It's almost time to say goodnight, isn't it?
It is almost, yeah.
Yeah.
This is Oberfuse and Secret Tattoo.
How's this from Emma Wonkies?
I think it is,
yeah. Yeah, get the email up as well.
Okay.
I took a look at you straight away. There's nothing in the world I wouldn't do. Oh, I would overthrow all the things I know, break all taboos, just to live my life with you.
Up, let's see what she's been doing the weekend. Anyhow, how was your weekend? Well, mine was normal. Yours was uphill, down dale,
yeah,
and
you
stuff.
Don't go
like
any places, do you? Don't go away
weekends.
I'm
not driving. I'm not driving and stuff. Yeah. Like, no, I don't. Why is a cab driver for
how many
years?
Don't you like you taking her away?
Well, to be fair, this weekend we was at Cove, as I told you then, because it's a grand old happy birthday as well to Frankie and in Brooke, my granddaughters.
Oh right,
yeah, four.
Okay.
Oh, see that cut
I
there?
Like Colson.
See that cut there?
Yeah.
That's little Frankie.
Yeah, right, okay.
Got claws. Yeah. She's getting hold of me. Like, it's the only time they ever talk to me in the fight, mate. I'll go, come here, give your granddad a kiss. Bugger all.
Wallop.
Well, talk to your granddad, but it's grand, like, nothing. Do you want to fight? There they are, they're all over you.
Yeah.
Wild kids. There you go. No, so anyhow, she was up to her ears in, blimey, hey, painting again. Wonder what she was going to be up in her ears. Skirting boards. They're a bastard to paint, aren't they, as well, skirting boards?
They are.
They are, aren't they?
I like painting.
Yeah, I know, but you have to, like, if you've got carpet, you have to put your masking thing there, don't you? Because you get all on your white, all on your blue carpet. And the staircase. But the house is coming along nicely. I'm absolutely chuffed about that, right? Emma Wonkies.
Rachel.
Back in... I tell you what I what I have to put up with here.
So I'll cut that bit.
Oh dear. Well, we have to kick off the week, the single from London's Uber Fuse, Secret Tattoo. Have you ever had a...
No, I've never
had
a secret tattoo.
Yeah, no,
I know.
Tom Robinson, BBC, introducing Sherry Anderson's vocals, reaches out the headphones from bar one and shakes your ears. It's gorgeous, it's upbeat, it's accessible yet quirky. Classy and well-made pop music. We love it. That's brilliant. Secret Tattoo follows their single 4, which we also did play that. So big up to Uberfest. It's at U, that's OOBER Fuse. I nearly said Uberfest. Because an Oktoberfest, didn't I?
Of course,
like, yeah. In Birmingham we have one. You're making me laugh now. Oh, come on. Anyway, it's time to say goodnight, isn't it?
Yeah. And sorry, you know, we haven't had time to play all the tracks, but...
No, because we didn't have a lot, because someone went on holiday, didn't
they? Yeah. The tracks we haven't had time to play will go straight into a massive, massive 24-hour playlist. So.
Well, to be fair, everything goes onto the playlist, don't it?
Yep, okay.
So keep listening, guys, 24/7, and you will... here your tracks if they've been on the Biscuit Boys show, if you've sent them in to tracks@sports-radio.co.uk, if Adam J has played it on Adam's Electric Legoland, if they've been on Rachel Brown's top 10. All of these tracks are on the folders. They will be on our 24/7 station. So it's just a case of keep listening and keep tuned. Because we've got Dumma O'Flynn talking to me at the Shaman's Cross pub in Solihull all about the In Music Festival. So you better get your arse into gear and get it done. Okay?
Okay.
Good night. God bless. Thanks for listening.
I'm going out with The Brazen. Good night.